Okay, to make this forever match, at least my version, I'm going to need a ruler. I'm going to make mine 18 to 24 inches long. I got me an old screwdriver that I've kind of filed down just to use to push with if I need to. I'm using 3-ply number 28 natural jute. You can pick this up at Walmart. Anywhere is cheap. Okay, I got the, in this case, I'm going to be using a 30-06 shell casing that I've drilled out to 5/16 inch, which would match the bullet side. Got me a pair of scissors. Got me some candle wax that I'm melting in my hot plate. I have my brass polish because I want to polish up that shell casing. And I need to tell Rita I found that sock that I was missing. Oh, and probably most importantly, got some coffee. Oh, and I forgot, I need a nail. Now with my jute twine, I'm going to make a 36 inch cut. So I've got a 36 inch strand off my jute twine. And as you can see, I doubled it. I'm moving it over to the side. And then I'm gonna get an 18 plus two or 20 inch piece. That'll be my third strand. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a double strand, doubled over, 36 inch piece, which are used for 2 18 inch strands, and then 1 20 inch strand. Now with the 20 inch strand, what I'm going to do is tie an overhand knot. Just a simple little overhand knot, and I'm going to do it right at the bitter end of the third strand. So there's the little overhand knot, and then I'm going to get the loop or the looped end of the 36 inch one. Where I've doubled it over, and I'm going to slide it through the overhand knot, then I'm going to cinch down on the overhand. So basically what that gives me is three strands. Okay, so we've got three lines, three strands, just like a lady braiding hair. It don't matter which one you start with, but you're going to take one of your outside ones and go over the middle one, keeping things fairly tight. That now becomes the middle. You take your next one and make it in the middle, coming over each time. And you just continue this process. Simple, very, very simple. there we have it. Now my old arthritic hands won't let me go too much further, but hopefully you can see what you're doing here. Okay, now what I'm going to do right now is just tie these into another simple overhand knot. This is called the bitter end, and I'm just tying all three of those strands together. I'm going to get rid of this knot after we let the candle wax take care of the line. Well, there you have it. I made two different sizes. Of course, that's the 30-06, but then I also made them for 5.62 NATO casings, which is typical for, I think, your AR-15s. I used the 2-ply jute twine for that, and the hole I drilled was 3/16 inch. Well, there's my versions of the Forever Match. If you make one, let me know how it turns out for you. You stay safe, stay strong, and stay vigilant. God bless you, and may God bless America. See ya.